Good morning, students. Welcome back to online lectures. We are moving on to unit 3. So here we have to discuss about the transcription. So to understand transcription, what are the enzymes involved in the transcription must be studied. So one of the main enzyme for the transcription is RNA polymerases. So coming to what is RNA polymerase? RNA polymerase catalyzes the formation of the phosphodiester bonds between the nucleotides. What is the function of RNA polymerase? It can form the phosphodiester bond between the nucleotides. So thereby polymerizes the nucleotides. And other functions are they uncoils the DNA. So to synthesize the RNA on the DNA, the DNA strands must be uncoiled. So this can be achieved by RNA polymerase and adds the nucleotides one at a time. So two functions, one it uncoils the DNA, other one is polymerizes the reaction in 5' to 3' fashion. And it uses the energy trapped in the nucleotides themselves to form the new bonds. What are the differences in DNA and RNA polymerases? RNA polymerase adds ribonucleotides, not DLC nucleotides. RNA polymerase does not have the ability to pre-read what they transcribe. What is proofreading? After the synthesis, whether the right nucleotides incorporated or not can be checked by the moving of the enzyme in backward direction. This is not processed by the enzyme RNA polymerase. RNA polymerase can work without a primer. RNA will have an error 1 in every 10,000 nucleotides, whereas for DNA, it is DNA polymerase, it is 1 in 10 cross nucleotides. What are the forms of RNA polymerases? Coming to bacteriophages, they have large single subunit RNA polymerases and they make certain specificity factors that alter the, that change the promoter recognition of post-bacterial enzymes. Coming to bacterial polymerases, they have 4 or more core subunits with exchangeable specificity factors. The core subunits are beta, beta prime, alpha, omega, and the specificity factor is sigma. Coming to archaebacteria, they have multiple subunits related to both bacteria and eukaryote. What are the eukaryotic RNA polymerases? They have many with subunits. Coming to polymerase 1, they have only the large ribosomal RNA subunit precursors, whereas for polymerase 2, all pre RNAs, some small nuclear RNAs, most small nucleolar RNAs used in rRNA processing. Coming to polymerase 3, mainly involved in tRNA synthesis, and they can have tRNAs, 5S rRNAs, U6 snRNAs, 7 SL splicing RNAs, and other small functional RNAs. Coming to mitochondria and chloroplasts, they have combination of phage-like and bacterial-like subunits. Coming to eukaryotic viruses, viruses which attack the eukaryotic cells, can take over host RNA polymerase or encode or in some large viruses like vaccinia virus. Coming to bacterial RNA polymerase, now we are studying about the bacterial RNA polymerase isolated in bacterial extracts in 1960 by independent groups. They are discovered by Samuel Rees and Gerard Herbig. They are responsible for synthesis of all three types of RNA species. They are mRNA, rRNA and tRNA. RNA polymerase is a huge enzyme, that means a big enzyme, about 460 kilodalton, made of 5 subunits. Coming to E. coli RNA polymerase structure, they have 5 subunits. There are 2 alpha subunits, 1 beta subunit, 1 beta prime subunit, 1 omega subunit, comprises 4 enzymes. Then sigma factor, specificity factor adds to the above subunits, they comprises 4 enzymes. Here you can see the picture. That means 2 alpha subunits and 2 beta subunits, they are required for polymerization. When sigma factor is attached to this, polyenzyme is produced. It is required for correct initiation of transcription and binding to the promoter region. Coming to the subunits individually, alpha subunit molecular weight is 36.5 kilodalton, encoded by RPOAG and required for core protein assembly, and also play a role in promoter recognition and involved in assembly of beta subunit to the beta prime subunit. Coming to beta subunit, molecular weight is 151 kilodalton, encoded by RPOBG and DNA binding active center. This is DNA binding active center, whereas rifampicin drug inhibits the beta subunit, thereby it unable to bind to the DNA. Beta prime subunit, molecular weight is 155 kilodalton, encoded by RPOCG, responsible for binding to the template DNA and this uses two magnesium ions for catalytic function of the enzyme. Coming to omega subunit, molecular weight is 91 kilodalton, encoded by RPM of Z gene, restores denatured RNA polymerase to its functional form in vitro. It has been observed to offer a protective chaperone function to the beta prime subunit in mycobacterial species. So omega subunit protects the beta subunit. Coming to E. coli RNA polymerase, the processivity of E. coli, that means number of nucleotides added per second, is about 40 nucleotides at 37 degrees, and it requires magnesium ion. Whereas RNA polymerase of T3 and T7 phases are having single polypeptides with processivity of 200 nucleotides per second. The enzyme has non-spherical structure with a projection flanking a cylindrical channel. That means structure is non-spherical and it has a projection flanking a cylindrical channel. The size of the channel suggests that it binds directly to 16 base pairs of DNA. That means the channel binds to 16 base pairs of DNA. Whereas the complete enzyme occupies 16 base pairs of the DNA. See the structure of the enzyme binding to the DNA. And you can see here that on the template strand, RNA is synthesized without any primer help. RNA initiates the polymerization reaction directly on the spanning of 60 base pairs length of the DNA. Here the flanking channel occupies the 16 base pairs and around 40 nucleotides per second can be synthesized. What is about the sigma factor? Sigma factor is a specificity factor that binds to core enzyme to convert the holo enzyme. It is encoded by RPODG. It has a critical role in promoter recognition. The main function of the sigma factor is promoter recognition. What is promoter? It promotes the transcription, the start site of the transcription, but is not required for transcription elongation. So initially, to initiate the transcription, sigma factor is required. For the elongation, it is not required for the enzyme. It recognizes the correct promoter site by decreasing the affinity of the enzyme at the non-specific DNA sequences. The amount is only 30% to amount of the enzyme. Each sigma factor recognizes a particular sequence of nucleotides upstream from the gene. Upstream means from the transcription start site, the above region is called upstream, the below region is called downstream. So promoter is present the above region of the transcription site. And here the sigma 70 looks for exactly minus 35 sequence, that is TTGACA sequence, and minus 10 sequences. So two sequences can be recognized by sigma 70 factor, known as Tata box for minus 10 and TTGA repeated sequence for minus 35. Other sigma factors look for another sequence. The match need not always be exact. That means different sigma factors have different sequences to identify. The better the match, the more likely transcription will be initiated. What are the alternative sigma factors? Alternative sigma factors can be classified into two structurally unrelated families. There are sigma 70 and sigma 54. Although no sequence conservation exists between sigma 70 and 54 like family members, both types bind to core RNA polymerase. Promoter structures recognized by sigma 54 RNA polymerase differ from those recognized by 70 RNA polymerase. Here you can see sigma 54 RNA polymerase recognizes minus 24 and minus 12 sequences, whereas sigma 70 RNA polymerase recognizes minus 35 and minus 10 recognition sequences. And these are the various sigma, E. coli sigma factors. There are sigma 70, sigma 54, sigma 38, sigma 28, sigma 24, and sigma 19. They are all of different types of the specificity factors encoded by different genes, and they are mostly of having specificity toward the specific sequences on the DNA. For example, sigma 70 is known as housekeeping sigma factor, are also called primary sigma factor, that transcribes most genes in growing cells, makes the proteins necessary to keep the cell alive. Whereas for sigma 54, this is nitrogen limitation sigma factor. Whereas sigma 38, this is the starvation or stationary phase sigma factor. Whereas 32 factor, it is a heat shock sigma factor. It is turned on when exposed to heat. Whereas 28 factor, it is the flagellar sigma factor. Whereas 24 factor, it is the extra cytoplasmic or extreme heat stress sigma factor. So this is all about the RNA polymerase. In next session, we will see the transcription process. Thank you.